Rick's Tool Time.
Hello, welcome to Rick's Tool Time. This week we're going to take a look at the TIS 455. Now Mark's going to explain what it actually is.
Well, actually it's a TIS 455 line splitter.
Oh, right, okay.
I often refer to it as a contraption because that's what it looks like. But yeah, the line splitter allows you to basically plug the unit into the wall, plug an appliance into that end, and then we split all the different denominations of the cable feeding an appliance so that firstly, if we wanted to, we could check what current the appliance is running at. We could also check what is disappearing down the earth.
Yep.
But most importantly, for earth leakage, we can clamp round where we split the live and the neutral. Importantly, that will give us the accurate earth leakage value. Whatever's going down the live should be coming back down the neutral. Anything that's not is pure earth leakage.
And what are these connectors for?
So they then allow you, Rick, at the same time, particularly if you're looking at the current to the appliance itself, you can measure the voltage. You've got the voltage, you've got the current. You can check what sort of power the appliance is running at the same time.
Now then, Rick from the future here. Now Mark has explained the features of the line splitter. Let's see how it works in real life. Here's our old microwave, which we pensioned off when the Makita battery-powered one arrived. Gary has a habit of leaving cups of tea to go cold all over the unit, so let's bring them, or at least one of them, back to life with some of these microwaves. While that's warming up, we can check the current draw of the appliance by clamping our current clamp around this area marked X1. We can also connect our meter between V and N terminals to measure the line voltage, and now, with the miracle of maths, we can work out the power. So power is equal to voltage times current. So the microwave is using 1580 watts. So that's just shy of 1600 watts. Of course, I haven't factored in the power factor in my simple calculation. The rating is, however, similar to what is on the rating plate on the side. Perhaps we've identified this appliance as a rogue operator, which is tripping one of our pesky RCBOs. We have two options to measure the leakage current directly on the protective conductor. However, this is not a true value as the appliance has a metal frame and is sitting on a metal cabinet, which could give an alternative path to earth. We've got to remember that Gary is stuck in the 17th edition of the regs and used to scattering earth clamps around with gay abandon. So as an alternative, you could measure the differential between the line and neutral conductors by clamping on here, which also gives us the true leakage current. You can then compare the two readings to help in your fault finding. If we look at this Apple laptop power supply, we can measure 0.4 milliamps of leakage current. That Stephen Jobs has a lot to answer for. Well, that's me done here. So back to the solar and storage show with me and Mark.
Brilliant, cheers Mark. So that's the TIS 455. Let me know what you think. Is it great or is it a gimmick? Get your votes in, but till then, I'll see you on the flip side. Ta-da.
Rick's Tool Time.